Well, hello everyone, I'm Yanni from BU Gaming, and we are to back in BugOut. And yeah, I have started over. There was no forced restart after the last update that they published, I think a day ago or something like that. But they added a collapsible storage, which of course I wanted, and I didn't get that in my previous game, so I kind of had to start over to get access to this. But let's just try and pop it down and see how this is gonna work. So that would be one. There we go. So now we have a tiny, tiny little storage. Okay, let's just put you over here somewhere. There we go. And let's see, how much space do we get in you? Ooh, that's actually not bad. Oh, why do I already have large branches in there? Maybe I've tried to pick some up that I didn't actually have in my, or have room for, I don't know. Okay, but let's just put some more in there. What am I gonna need? I made some firewood on the way up here. I've made some ropes on the way up here too. We do have some sticks. Let's put some of those away. Let's put some of our fiber away here. I actually found 10 pine branches, so maybe we can make one of the small shelters on the way. There's another difference between the previous update and this one. You don't start with an axe now. I don't know why they removed it again. That was very short that we have had access to an axe. We can still craft one, however, so that's probably something we're gonna try to do. For that, we need a rock, a stick, and a fiber rope. So let's just get that. Why will you not let me craft it? I have room. Does it somehow count the storage or something by accident? Because we do have room for it, so why won't you let me craft a hatchet? Craft reward collection 4. Okay, I am not quite sure why it's saying that, but okay, well, let's try and see if it will let me craft something else. There was this pine lean-to, which is the smallest of shelters. Well, I think so. Very simple shelter. It takes 8 pine branches, 5 light branches, 10 sticks, and a fiber rope. Can I craft you? You don't have the required items to craft pine lead to. Why not? I have the pine branches. Oh, I'm missing one large branch. Okay. Well, let's take one of these back then. And let's see, are you gonna let me? Okay, so that you'll craft, but you won't craft the axe. That's peculiar. I actually have less storage space now. But for some reason it wouldn't let me craft the axe. Okay, well, we're gonna make the pine lead too. And then, of course, we're gonna want a campfire. So you don't start with an axe now, but you actually have a fire tender to start with. So you start with a cooking pot, a fire tender, and a sleeping bag. And then you have this stew beef and a smoked jerky, and that's all you start with now. And I actually found some blueberries, some muscadine. I found a good, nice supply of some herbs here. Actually, I found both basil, sage, bloodroot, and peppermint, but they have added more herbs to the valley area, which is where we are at, in the last update. So that seems to be helpful. They're still a little hard to spot if you don't know what you're looking for, but it is definitely easier than it was before. And there is also other changes. Okay, while Liz is working on that, let's just close these down. They have removed the colliders so that you don't get stuck on these tree stumps. Before I would actually sometimes get stuck on these. Like, I would walk up to them and then try to jump over, and I would actually get stuck on them. But there's no collider now, so you can easily pass them by. But what I really noticed, which is just awesome, is that they... where's the other one? No, there's one more. There we go. They have improved it so you can get up and down hills, because before... Let's see if I can actually do it here. I kind of, on the way here, almost got myself lost because I kind of wandered off into the forest looking for some resources. I don't know if this might be too steep, but let's just see. I don't know if we can walk up this one. Oh, we can actually. Wow, that is amazing. Before we couldn't actually get up any, even the small hills. Like over here, you would assume you could get up these, but that was not an option before, but it is now. So that is cool. It makes it much more enjoyable to move around in the area. I did notice one thing though, that the frames per second seems to have dropped a little bit, at least for me in this with this update. I don't know what they have changed that have caused that. So I'm actually, I have changed it to running on medium if the quality doesn't look quite as it did last time. I've been running it on high before, but still, and the frames per second are not that good, but my PC also isn't the best. I just noticed that it's not as good as it was before. Okay, how are we doing with this? Did I finish that? Let's see, pine lean 2. No, that's still taking a while. Okay, what else are we gonna need? We have some large branches. I want to make a bow drill so we can get an ember. So for that, we're gonna need firewood, which we have. Fiber rope, which we have. Sticks, we have. I have more in storage. Okay, well, let's just try and look around a little bit then while we're waiting for this lean-to to get sorted. See if we can get lucky and find some herbs or something, or at least just some resources. It definitely isn't always easy to find any of these, especially the herbs are pretty, can be pretty tricky to spot. But often it helps to look for something that is a little bit darker than these natural plants or these plants and grass that we have. Let's get that. Oh, there we go. Yep, right there, basil. Yep, okay, well, we found one of those. Nice. I haven't seen any snails yet, but they are pretty hard to spot. That's not a snail, right? Nope. Just a coloration of the ground. Okay, can we find any other ones? You can see sometimes they're in between all of this, and then it can be really hard to spot anything. And nope, nothing. Okay. Nope. Oh, yes, right there. Aha, peppermint. Yep. And I do believe it's right here. There's also usually some peppermint that spawns in, but I already collected that. Can we find more over here? Oh, I got my lean-to. Okay, let's go back and get that place down. But I really love that they added a little bit of storage, because it's kind of limiting how much you can actually carry, which makes sense. I don't mind that much that I can't, even though I'm quite the hoarder usually in all games, so I like having a big inventory, but not being able to store anything, that I really don't like. So I'm really happy that we have this tiny storage now. Lean-to, pine lean-to, there we go. Yep, let's take you, put you in here, and let's see. Okay. Maybe make a little area over here. Ooh, come on. Okay. Not much room, but it is a little shelter, so we could put our backpack in, or our sleeping bag in there, I guess, to sleep. What is... got a little pop-up. Oh, I think it's this one, actually. So if we take our sleeping bag... I don't know if this is actually, if the shelters have any function apart from just being kind of decorative, but it would kind of make sense that you would see. Now we have our little sleeping bag underneath that. It's not completely covered, but that's okay. And we can sleep in there. Nice. Okay, so what else? What else? What else? We are gonna get... let's take some of these sticks out. We can make some more fiber rope. We have some more branches. Yep. Okay, so if we go in here, we're going to need a bow drill. We don't start with one of those anymore, so let's make one of those. Sticks, fiber rope, and firewood. Okay, that's also gonna take a while. It always takes takes a while to make all of this, but I really want a campfire. So we can place down our cooking pot like we did last time, and then go and see if we can get water, because they also improved the streams, like the creek and the small springs, so hopefully it will be easier now to collect some water, even if it's dirty water from the creek. So if we get the boat well, then what else are we gonna need? We don't technically need wood. What was we needed wood chips for before? That was for the fire tinder, but we already started with that, so we don't need it. Then campfire. Okay, so you guys might have noticed last time that the fire kind of went out on the campfire, even though it was still actually working. That is something they're gonna look into fixing. I don't know if they have done it already, but they're gonna fix it so the fire doesn't kind of disappear when it's still working. But eventually we are gonna have to add fuel to the campfire to keep it going, which kind of makes sense, but for right now it's not really needed. So we're gonna need the hot ember, which we should be able to make with the boat drill, and then we need firewood. Well, I still have 9, so that should be fine. That's for the campfire. Then we have these other tents. We're gonna need a lot of pine branches and large branches, so that's not gonna be the first thing we're gonna do. Then there's the tap. I wanna go and see actually if we can buy this from the trader, because otherwise I have no idea where we can find tap if we're gonna have to go and go out explore and try and find it. But let's just see if he was actually selling that, because I don't remember what he was selling exactly. Let's see, you have, well, there's the hand planner. We're gonna need 250 credits for that, but there's no tap. So yeah, I don't know where we're supposed to get that. Okay, but it sounds like we got our bow drill, so let's get that going. Ooh, it's raining. Okay, well, let's go back over here. Oh, there's actually a stick right there. Let's steal that. Yep, gonna be handy. So, got the boat wheel. Let's hit B, put it in here, let's put it down. And where are we gonna put our campfire? We're kind of gonna have our storage there. Let's just put our little boat wheel over here. There we go. And let's hit F, hot ember. For that we need the fire tinder, which we already have. So let's craft this. Okay, that shouldn't take too long. But of course we can always make a fire tinder. I don't know why they changed this, because I don't really feel like you technically needed to have this. You could easily make it yourself. And I think it's okay we don't start with an axe, because now we can craft one. So, and it's pretty easy to craft one and find the resources for it. So I'm pretty okay with us not having that. It's kind of like in most survival games, you have to craft an axe. Okay, there we go. Got the hot ember. So then we have campfire, hot ember, and firewood. Yep, let's craft that up. And what's the next thing we want to do then? I know we did this last time, but that's just how it's going to be a few times here in the beginning, that we're going to be doing things again. But this is a little bit of a different start, because we don't have quite the same items available than we had last time. So that's mainly why I'm showing you guys these things. Fish basket. We need 10 sticks. We need a few more sticks, then we can make the fish basket, which we were actually working on last time. I had actually made it ready, but then I had to start over. Yep, that's just how it is. There we go. So now we have our campfire. I'm thinking, yeah, let's put you over here. Nice. And F, there we go, charcoal. Yep, well, we have this. Let's take the cooking pot. And then we are gonna, how did I do this last time? Like that, I think. Yep, okay, awesome. And that means we have, of course, the boiled water, which we don't really need to make. We don't have dirty water. Cooked fish and cooked small game. Okay, but now we have our campfire going, so that is awesome. Nice. He looks a little bit funny when he's looking like that. He's turning his head. He has an amazingly stretchable neck. So, fiber bandage, that might actually be something to do too. And then the fist basket, so we needed some sticks for it. We need to find some snails. I don't know if we can use the fish basket without having snails, so that's something we're gonna have to go and get. Then there's the woodcrafting station, but for that we're gonna need to make some money, because the logs we can easily get, we can just cut down stuff with our axe. Where did my axe go, actually? Oh right, I never made an axe, because we couldn't. Okay, let's see if we can do it now. But for this, yes, we need the hand planner, which is the main issue. And then we have firewood, fiber rope, the tab. I don't know where to get that, but we do have this pine tent, so I needed to find more pine branches. I don't know if they have changed the trees yet, so you can cut them down so we get branches from them, or if we're gonna have to go and find all the branches on the ground like before. I know that one of the developers at least said that he wanted to change that. So let's see, you're gonna go... No? Huh. Okay, well, that's just how it is then. So I'm gonna report that to them, of course, that I can't craft my axe for whatever reason. I don't have anything in my tool belt, and my storage definitely isn't full. Okay, so fish basket. Oh, we need a few sticks. Close you down. We have 9, so if we can just find one more stick. Actually, I want to try and head down to the water and see if we can fill up our canteen a little bit. There we go. Let's just drink a little bit of that and get some dirty water so that we can boil that up, because otherwise we're going to have an issue with drinkable water, because I haven't seen any springs nearby here so far. I'm sure there are some somewhere, but it's a matter of finding them, of course. We have the one that is almost all the way back to the beginning, and I don't really want to run all the way back there all the time. So let's see if we can be allowed to. Yes. Okay, let's do this. Oh, it just doesn't give you the bar, but it does fill it up, as you can see. Nice. Okay, refill canteen. And then we just need to find a stick. Stick, stick, stick. Oh, there's a large branch. Let's get you. Come on, pick it up. Yep, okay. And actually, while we are at this anyway, we might as well make use of the time. So let's make some more bandages. Yep, cool. Let's pick you up. Then the question is how to find these snails, because they're very, very tiny and very, very hard to spot. And I don't know if there's any like better place to find it. I would assume somewhere where it's kind of wet. So I don't know if we have to kind of walk along the shore of the creek or something. If that would help us find them. Right now I just kind of want to find a stick, which I'm not having. Oh. There we go, nice. Okay, how's my bandage coming along? Not quite there yet. Was there anything else we needed for this? 4 fiber ropes. We have 5 left. And we have the 10 sticks now. Then we can make the fish basket. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Okay, so let's get some water boiling, and so we make sure we always have some of that, and let's get this fish basket going. There we go. Still need to find some of these snails, which I haven't had much luck with yet. It's not easy seeing anything here. That's one reason why, that's another reason why I would like to have first person view, because you kind of, it blocks your view sometimes when you're running around in a forest like this. Actually, we should also, what was that that popped up? Oh, I think it's this. Okay, come on. There we go. We should also be able to actually drop stuff on the ground now. But I think we are just going to use the storage for as long as we can. So we have a large branch. We needed fiber rope. We needed sticks. What else did we need? Because it doesn't disappear from your storage until it's actually crafted. So, okay, we have some rocks. which you need for the axe that we, for some reason, we can't really do anything with. Ooh, we have more branches, nice. And then we have the sticks. Fiber bandage still doesn't go in here. It's supposed to go in there, but it doesn't. And we have some extra pine branches. So this is what we need for this. Okay, let's eat some of these muscadine, actually. There we go. Not the most filling, but it is okay. Smoked jerky, what are you going to give us? 22, and you actually also seem to give us this. Okay, let's just use some of these and keep the other stuff for emergencies. There we go. It's not like your food goes down that fast, actually. Oh, it does say 4. Just really hard to see that there's actually 4 of them in here. Okay, so we have our fish basket. We need to get snails. And actually, I want to go and... getting stuck on my storage. I want to go and try and see if we're gonna sell some stuff. We are gonna get some recipes for peppermint and sage and all that stuff at some point. But right now, I think I kind of just want to sell all of it so we can get that hand planner. Oh, can I get this? Thank you. And let's see how much we can make with this guy. So how do I sell stuff to you? I can buy this, but what if I want to sell something? How do I do that? How much do you want? Sell price 12. Okay, if I click. Ooh. Okay. Yep. Click the button to pick the desired amount. Shift click adds 10 instead of 1. Well, I only have 1. So if I say accept. Oh, nice. We have 12 already. Okay, let's go in here and we have 10 peppermint. So let's just do this. And was it shift click? Oh, not there. Shift click plus. Oh, okay, like this. No? Shift? No? How am I supposed to add? I know I can type like that. Okay, you only get 1 for each, so you really don't get a lot of these. Blood roots, they give. Sell price 20, buy price 45. Okay, well, we are gonna sell you. Accept. Sage, also only 1 each. So let's just. Okay, this doesn't seem to work actually, the plus and the minus. Clicking it doesn't do anything. Click the button to pick this. Shift click. Yeah, shift click doesn't do anything there, and these don't seem to do anything, so I'm not quite sure. It seems a little buggy. Okay, well, we can do it like this, as long as you can sell stuff. And the basil is also not very valuable. So we definitely would like to find more of those blood roots. We only have 46, we need to get 250, guys. Wow. Yeah, that's gonna take a while. To get up to that, we're going to have to go exploring some. We can, of course, sell this for 100. We can not sell these. Not sell you. And not sell you. But I don't really want to sell everything because we do need... How's this coming along? Oh, it's almost done. Because we also do need to have some food, so I don't want to sell everything unless we are in a pretty good state. With finding stuff. Apparently there are apple trees or something that we can find. And yeah, there's actually one thing I was thinking. Now we have the fish basket. Nice. Okay, let's go over here. Oh, I love this little storage actually. Ooh, okay. Might not have been the best place to place this because now I have an issue with accessing that instead of... now I can't access it because it's too close to the fire, maybe? Okay, right. Fire starter, hot ember, no, I don't want that. Okay, let's pick you back up then. You're gonna let me access my storage then? Nice, thank you. Okay, so we have a fiber rope. We have our bow drill, which we don't need right now. We have our fish basket, but I don't think we can use it. Unless we got some snails, maybe, but we could try. Got some 6. So let's just try and go down with it. And then we'll just have to go and see if we can find some snails. And let's take you and head back down to the river. Try and go reasonably straight so we can find it again. If we're going to place it here. Oh, give me that. And okay, let's see. Apparently there were some issues with it before, so it had to be kind of somewhere where there was, I don't know, shallow or something. Oh, I forgot to boil some water. Well, I can do that later. Let's put you there. And okay, so how does this thing work? Okay, it doesn't seem like we can place it anywhere here. Well, we might also have to have, maybe we have to have snails or not. That's the thing, I don't really know. If we do. Yep, I can refill my canteen, which I don't really want to do. Okay, well, maybe. I'm not sure how this is supposed to work. We might have to get the snails first. I would just assume you could place it and then you could refill it with snails, but that might not be the deal. Well, not snails, but fish bait. Nope, doesn't seem to be an option. Okay, well, let's put you in there. And okay, where in the world are we gonna find... Oh, stop it. Okay, if we just... It's 2-1, no, okay. Okay, that seems to be a little... Okay, if we put it in there again. And let's say 2-3, no. Okay, let's move it over here. 1-2, no. Okay, it's a little buggy. It gets stuck on my screen. Okay, well, let's see. Snails. Usually snails like being where there is water or where it's kind of moisty. So that's the question where we would find some of them. Okay, well, I think that's just what we're going to have to try and do next time. Or at least I'm going to try and see if I can find some snails so we can test this thing out. And then maybe we'll go try explore a little bit next time. Depends if I get some resources collected first, then we might try to craft some more stuff. But I think maybe we're gonna try, we could try wandering down the road actually and see if we can find something there of interest. Snails are also easier to spot on the road, though I didn't see anyone any coming to the trade station this time around, so... Snail. Okay. I don't know if there's like a trick to finding them, or if it's just completely random where they might be. But we're just gonna have to see if we can have some luck with that. We're gonna need these, because we need a 20 for the other shelter. And yeah, once I reboot the game, I'm sure this thing will stop being in front of me. But that is another little thing to report to the developers, so they can fix it. Okay, well, ooh, this has respawned. Nice. So, yep, thank you for watching, guys. If you're playing the game yourself, then let me know how it's going. And if you have found anything interesting on the map, I haven't actually had time to go out and really explore or anything at all. But I have seen a lot of screenshots, especially Andrew, who's one of the very, very active testers of the game. Takes a lot of screenshots. I think he's seen a huge part of the map already, because he spends a lot of time exploring. And there are definitely some gorgeous places, like waterfalls and stuff. So, yep, it's just a matter of heading out there and trying to find some of it. Which reminds me, actually, I was about to say this earlier and then I got distracted. I am going to write down my coordinates. You can see in the top left corner, we do have a compass. And I would suggest writing that down, your coordinates, because at least to me, this map is not very helpful. I have no idea how to figure out where we are. I don't know if that black line is supposed to be the creek, or if it's the road, or what it is in the middle. Apparently there's a lake, so I assume that's in the middle. If we can find a lake, then maybe we might have an idea of where we are. But generally, if you have to find your way back to here, it might be a good idea to just write down the coordinates. And that will make it a little bit easier. Anyway, thank you for watching, guys. And as always, do take care and happy gaming.